Hello world! As you can see by the title of this video, today I'm going to be sharing with you five things that I would have done differently in learning to code if I could start over. No useless advice that you won't be able to apply, but only useful things based on my own experience. To be honest with you, I don't have so much professional experience in software development and software engineering, but I still believe that things I'm going to be sharing with you are very practical, applicable to anyone who start their career path or learning to code, and I hope that it will be useful for you. If you want to learn more about my professional experience, I have a proper video on this topic. Check it out, link in the description. Are you ready? C'est parti! The first thing, consistency. Well, easy to say, be consistent and regular, and very easy to say, but not easy to follow, honestly. And I wasn't the exception. Being consistent is a crucial thing, especially in learning new things, and it's not only about programming, it's not only about coding. And if you don't want to waste your time and have progress, have real progress, you have to be consistent. I give you an example of my own experience and mistakes I made. When I say, when did I start learning programming? When did I start changing my career? I always say that it's all started with the 42 school when I was entering it in the beginning of 2020. But I lie a little bit because I had some attempts in learning programming in 2018. And I would follow some courses on YouTube. I would find some websites like 100 Days of Code or something like that. And I would like sit in front of the computer all of the weekend. I was so much motivated. And then like I wouldn't touch the code. I wouldn't even open the computer for the days. And it was a huge, huge mistake. Do you remember anything from this period? Of course not. So when you don't repeat things, when you don't come back and forth again and again, and when you just close your computer for days and not open it, you easily forget everything you learned. And like everything you learned was a sort of a waste of the time. Because the chunks of the new knowledge that are created are like lost without the repetition and consistency. The good book about this, I think, which explains this concept better than I do, is made by Barbara Oakley, and it's called Learning How to Learn. She also has a course on Coursera. I will put all of the links in the description of this video. And in terms of the time, how much time do you have to sacrifice when learning to code? Well, it all depends on your capacity of being focused. For some people, it's very hard to focus, but I know that this ability to be focused, you can, you can increase it gradually. So you can start from 15 minutes of deep learning, of the being really focused, and then it will be 30 minutes, and then it's up to 4 hours, and then you can increase it up to 8 hours, like a normal working day, with some breaks, of course. The key idea is to be consistent and study every single day. One day off per week, of course, if you really need a break. Second thing, making coding your number one priority. As I told, ideally you would come to the rhythm when you work 8 hours, study coding, study programming 8 hours per day as a, as a job, as your day-to-day job. It means that you'll be studying all day, and it means that you won't have any time for any side jobs, for any other learning activities. And my own example, when I started learning programming, I used to have a part-time job, which took me like half of the time I would study and half of the time I would work of my productive hours, let's say, and which meant, which ended up that I was almost burned out. I didn't achieve the results, I didn't achieve the goals and outcomes that I set up to myself. I haven't always had enough energy, I was frustrated. But then I just decided to stop working and to be fully concentrated on studies. And that was a huge, huge breakthrough. So I just realized that I need to set up priorities. I made programming my number one priority and I saw the progress. Third thing, computer science. If I had more time and if I were about to choose my first career path, I think I would enter the university for the computer science degree. On my daily basis at work, I always feel a little bit lack of basics of the knowledge that I would have taken at the university, which wasn't the case. But wait. Steve Jobs, Mark Zuckerberg, and all of this outstanding people in tech, they quit the university, right? Like, it means that it's useless. Well, depends on your situation, on your personality, right? Depends on your background and how much time do you have, what is your potential. But I believe that generally, if you're like have zero knowledge in what you're going to study at the university, it will be useful because it's the program done by professionals, by academic professionals who have a lot, enormous knowledge they want to share with you. And it's done, you know, there is a system behind all of this and it won't make any harm. But speaking of the university, I would strongly recommend you to look through the program to see if there is any applicable projects, if they use recent technologies, recent tools that you could apply in your future job. That is important. The second thing is if the university has partnerships with tech companies, which is also important when searching for the internship. It would be easier if the university has the partnerships. My own experience, I started at 42 school. If you don't know, it's a completely free school where you have a lot of flexibility in terms of you don't have any lectures, any professors. You study on your own. It's just you, computer, projects, Google, and your peers. And it's knowledge sharing between all of the students. And for some people it's a good approach, for some people not. I really liked it. It's really my thing, but it has some drawbacks. As I described, I still have some lack of fundamentals, which I'm trying to compensate by reading books, by watching conferences. And that's what I would have done differently if I had some time. If you want to learn more about the school, I have plenty of videos on this topic, and I'll put the link in the description of the official website of the school so you can learn about it more. And the fact that I learned how to be autonomous really helped me at work. In my professional experience, when I didn't have any fear to start a new project, to start all over again when I was changing the companies. And that's I also want you to pay attention to if you are going to choose the university, so that you can see real projects in the program. If you are in the middle of studies, if you haven't have any applicable project, just try to do your own. It will really, really help you in your professional career in the future. The fourth thing, would I follow only one career option? Many software engineers, they advise to choose the field in software engineering, like web development, mobile development, or security, or data science at the beginning, so that you have like a straight path, the knowledge, the technologies you are going to study, they will all apply in this sphere. But I don't agree with that, honestly, because how would I know that it's my thing, that I would be loving to do it if I haven't tried? How to choose, right? Just following the trend because it pays me well, or because it's easier to learn. It won't work at the end because you won't be doing things you like. You won't be passionate about that if it's not choice based on your needs, based on what you like to do. As for my own experience, I started with the pure C, then jumped to the project-oriented programming. I did some project in C++, Java. I touched a little bit DevOps, and it really helps me right now with Jenkins and my day-to-day life of a software engineer. And I ended up working first in sort of a mix of the web development and data engineering in Java, and then I jumped into the web development and TypeScript. in my case, touching a little bit of this and that helped me to be more flexible and not fear of trying something new. But I really think in my case, I should right now stop searching for new things and keep focusing on things I'm doing right now, web development, TypeScript, at least for some years, to be really professional in that. Otherwise, if I would start security, I would start all over again. I would be zero because I have zero knowledge in this field. So it means that I won't be any good in any sphere. By the way, sometimes things I learned at school with C language helps me in day-to-day life as well. Because, you know, when setting up a project, there are some bash comments which I wouldn't understand if I haven't done my proper mini shell. In short, try different things, then choose, then follow that. And don't follow trends a lot. The fifth thing, last, but I still have a lot of things to say to you. Anyway, build your career early. It means that start searching for your first internship at school. Because nothing will replace the real experience, professional experience you might get there as an intern and then as a software engineer. You will always be feeling, oh, I'm not good enough, oh, I don't have enough skills, I don't have enough knowledge, I still have to study plenty of things, I don't fit the job description. You might feel this way, but just do it, just try it. And personally, I think I started at the right time my career, when I wasn't still ready enough, but was ready enough. And if not the circumstances, I think I might have given up at some point and, you know, stopped trying in technical interviews if I didn't succeed in my second one, I guess. Yeah. So if you don't succeed, please don't stop. Try again and again, second time, third time, fourth time. And you will nail your technical interview at the end with the experience of being interviewed, with the technical interviews give you a lot of, you know, things to think about, to practice. You will also learn on the go, let's say. And at the end, you will nail your technical interview. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope it was useful. Don't forget to give it a like. Subscribe to my channel and leave the comment if you have any thoughts. Thank you again. See you in my other videos. Bisous. Bye bye.